I know him. I've had the fortune of knowing him very closely. Huge respect to have him over here. And what better discussion than to talk about team management. But unfortunately, in the times of crisis, because the world, as we know, is changing every second, every minute. We are all grappling with new ways of working. You know, like in Bengaluru, I'm here, and people have started coming to office in very small numbers, but in many cities, it's still closed. It's very, very different reality. So let's take a step back. And, you know, Saravir, I want to ask you, what has changed fundamentally when it comes to the world of work? What do you see as changing fundamentally?
Yeah, so I just said that. Thanks for the kind words. Yeah, I think, as you said, you know, a lot has changed in the last 2 months, right? I mean, even in January, we had no idea that this is what was in store for us this year. I think fundamentally what has changed, actually, I would divide the divide companies into two halves. So I think there is one set of companies which have had a huge loss in business, actually. So they are struggling to figure out what is the business model, what else should they do? What are the, you know, how much runway do they have? What's going to happen next? So those are, I think, a very stressful and a different set of circumstances. And then there is a few companies or a number of companies who are actually getting a lot of business out of this, you know, out of this current circumstance. And they are actually struggling or learning how to cope with, you know, demand, how to make sure that they can continue to serve customers. And, you know, both sets of companies have a very human problem, which is that every employee is a family member, is a human first, right? Some people have been separated from their family. Some people's, you know, parents are in different location, you know, spouses. So I think people are also coping first with what has hit them. And, you know, they're trying to figure out what they should do. And then, of course, like I said, depending on which camp you're in, you could either have the stress of reinventing your business model, or you have the, you know, maybe the good fortune of supporting demand, but in very difficult circumstances, right? I mean, if you have to do deliveries in this thing, there's a whole new set of challenges. So I think that's kind of the landscape. And I think, you know, it's a new world for a lot of us.
Yeah. You know, what are some of the key things that you look at when it comes to balancing the focus, the business focus and people focus? Because never before has it come out so starkly, right? We keep on talking about team, but there is business to run and then there is team. How are you looking at this?
Yeah, so what we've been trying to do at Policy Bazaar, and I think what we've been explaining to all our team leaders as well, is that, you know, see, this is the first time. See, we've had economic crises before, right? A lot of us have seen 2008. Some of us have even seen, you know, 1999 or, you know, 2003, whichever one you want. But I think for the first time, there is, at least in my experience, there is fear also of health, right? So there is a first time people are worried about what will happen to them. And it kind of crept upon us quite fast. Now, so what we have been telling people is that, first of all, look at the safety of your teams, because it is important. And sometimes, you know, we can't do much about it, right? Let's say there is a team member whose parents have to be taken to hospital or something like that. You may not be in a position to do anything. But by being there for that person, by empathizing, by, you know, even speaking to them, it makes a big difference to them. And I think, so I think the first part of any leader's job is really empathy. And I think in this kind of a situation, it has become even more important. The second, I think, is to declutter, because the truth of the matter is that I feel that most business leaders know their goals, right? Or should, at least. Now, the problem many times is that we know what we should be doing, but, you know, we end up doing many other things also, because it's good to do this also. Wo bhi kar lete, ye bhi kar lete. So I think, once you are a little bit comfortable or are clear about the health side, I think the next step is to stop doing, you know, discretionary activities. Because there is no point in this stage of creating artificial stress and, you know, doing things. So if you can, you know, declutter, focus on the few core business objectives that you have or your team has, then it helps to set the tone for the team. And I think that's the most important thing, that you want to set the right tone, you know, not giving, you know, unnecessary targets also. And yet, you know, you don't want things to completely, you know, fall apart either.